Hey guys, welcome to lesson 2 on how to optimize your hormone. In this video, you're going to learn why cortisol is so important in managing your hormone system. Hey everybody, it's me Amir. If you missed my last week's video on how to optimize your hormones, all you got to do is click the video right here. Now, when we look at the diagram again, you're gonna see that cholesterol is made into pregnenolone, and from pregnenolone, it's made to DHEA, from DHEA to testosterone and estrogen. The situation at hand today is, when we're looking at testosterone levels or estrogen levels, people are looking at, wait a second, it's either too high or too low. Let me add in some bioidentical hormone replacement therapy, synthetic hormone replacement therapy, or pharmaceutical drugs. They never actually stop and ask the question, wait a second, why are my hormone levels skewed in the first place? Let's reverse engineer your health. So if we know that pregnenolone right here is made from cholesterol, and then pregnenolone is made to DHEA, that means the testosterone and the estrogen is actually affected by pregnenolone, because this is the mother right here. Okay, this leads me now into the whole thing with cortisol. If I jump over here, cortisol, if you follow the arrow, will feed off of progesterone. Progesterone will feed off of pregnenolone. We like to call this as a pregnenolone steal. So in today's time, we have a fight or flight response constantly. What this means is we're in a stressed out situation 24/7. It's okay to be stressed out in an acute window, but when you're chronically stressed out, that means your cortisol is raised up 24/7 and your blood pressure is raised up 24/7. When you have a constant fight or flight scenario, your cortisol will constantly steal pregnenolone. And that's just one bad aspect. The second bad aspect is your pregnenolone only has a finite number of times it can be produced from cholesterol. So if we're looking at this again, and if this can only produce, say, 10 times, and cortisol is stealing pregnenolone 10 times, what happens then? Well, it's simple. Goodbye, pregnenolone. And that's why we're seeing right now a decline in how our hormones are functioning. We're not seeing healthy testosterone or estrogen levels. We're not seeing healthy DHEA levels, because at the end of the day, we're in a super stressed out state 24/7. Now you're probably wondering, well, why are we so stressed out? It's a great question. The first reason is a diet. You're either eating a diet not meant for your biochemistry, or most likely you're eating the SAD diet, standard American diet. Highly processed, refined grains, sugar, sweeteners, high fructose corn syrup, all this put together is raising your insulin, raising your cortisol, stealing your pregnenolone. Second, lack of sleep, not going to bed on time. And third, lack of exercise. Most people just sit on their butts all day. They don't even walk outside. They don't get vitamin D. They don't do nothing. So there's many cofactors to be considered when actually optimizing your hormones. And when we're looking at the diagram once again, it's pretty crucial to see that cortisol, your stress hormone, plays a pivotal role in your hormonal health. That begs the question, well, what can we do about it? How can we control cortisol? How can you de-stress? Well, I have a little list over here right now. First thing we gotta do is, or what I should say you gotta do is start the paleo diet. You hear me about advocating it nonstop. I like to call it the ancestral diet, the paleo diet, the whole foods diet. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just Google it, search it up. I'm actually gonna be making a video about it very soon. Second, I like to add adaptogenics. So these are little substances that can alleviate pressure from your adrenal glands where cortisol is made. So certain adaptogenics such as licorice root, rhodiola, ashwagandha, they're all really good at mitigating the effects of cortisol, relaxing you and giving you the necessary tools that your body deserves. Third thing is vitamin D. We're deficient in vitamin D. Vitamin D controls your T cells, controls your immune system. Actually, it's pretty known that it actually controls 10% of your epigenetic sequence. That means it controls how your DNA replicates. Finally, I like to add magnesium. We're completely deficient in magnesium. I don't care if you're eating organic foods, whole foods, our soil is depleted. So adding magnesium, trace minerals. Magnesium will mitigate the effects of cortisol. It relaxes your muscles and it's gonna de-stress you. I consider it mandatory that everybody incorporates magnesium into their lifestyle. And guys, finally, you know me, I preach about this almost in every single video. Sleep. Stop the BS, get to bed on time, stop making excuses. There's no such thing as excuse. You can't excuse your health, okay? Go to bed at 10 o'clock, give the care that your body deserves. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video today on how to optimize your hormones. As you can see, it's not really the hormones, but how you live your life, a lifestyle change that you need to do. Take this information, benefit from it, and you know what to do, guys. Subscribe to my channel, leave some comments, and catch my next week's video where I'm actually gonna do a lesson about parasites, mold, and food allergies, how they can actually affect your hormone sequence. And I'm gonna tie everything together and make a big master plan that you guys can optimize your hormones. Have a great week.